Yeah. In my white tee. Yeah. Call the Pipe Williams for the hype, please. They gon' wipe you before you wipe me. Unboxes of checks, not my Nikes. Cacti's not no iced tea. Got them bamboozled like I'm Spike Lee. You need more than Google just to find me. I just call a beta, get a hyphy.
Incredible, general.
I just start the label just to sign me. Me and Chase connected like we Siamese. We been on a run, feel like a crime spree. Talk to me nicely. I seen his face, seen it. Yeah, on his white tee.
Let's go. Yeah, call the Sprite people. Come on, hold on. Private flight franchise sites. On a private flight. Popped him in his hands, he was tight.
Caterpillar Rari, I fought to lift it up. I went on the stand, told the judge.
Hello, Cardinals. This is Fedor Mirza with you at the announcements. Last Thursday, we officially began the registration process for 2023 school year. During the course, students went over how to register for classes with their advisory teacher. The registration is completely online, and the window is now open for students to begin entering their course request in Student View. All requests must be submitted no later than Thursday, January 13th, with the window will be closing. Counselors will also be available for assistance before and after school outside the counseling office and also in the cafeteria at lunches during the registration window. This past weekend, members of Coon Rapids DECA competed at the Minnesota District 4 Career Development Conference. Among the 40 DECA members that attended the competition, there were 34 students that qualified for state in at least one event. Some of the highlights at the conference included 59 overall team or individual finalists for Coon Rapids High School. Coon Rapids had 10 students who qualified for state in two of the events. The special recognition goes to Olivia Larson, Thomas Samet, Cody Adland, Julia Dunton, Maya Kelly, Peyton Himley, Kate Garbo, and Harry Koval, who qualified for state in all three of the events. In addition to the state qualifiers, Tom Samet, Avi Kleur, Jason Stewart, Peyton Himley, Maddie Frosselway, and Eli Guthrie all earned the top 25 exam score at the conference. The students will be competing in March at the DECA Minnesota State Career Development Conference for the right to represent Minnesota DECA at the International Career Development Conference in Atlanta. These students will be competing in March at the DECA Minnesota State Career Development Conference for the right to represent Minnesota DECA in the International Career Development Conference in Atlanta, Georgia in April. All DECA members who attend should be applauded for their excellent showing. Lastly, Mr. Bloomberg and Ms. Lindahl would like to thank all DECA members who competed in District 4 competition for their respectful and professional behavior at the conference. Thank you and congratulations. Free community movies at CRHS Auditorium this month are on Friday, January 14th at 7 p.m. Disney Encanto, and on Monday, January 17th at 3 p.m. There will be the movie Selma. Enter door 1 or door 16. Concessions will be sold cash only, please. Save the date. There is a PSCO informational meeting February 3rd during early release. All students interested in participating in the PSCO post-secondary enrollment options next year must attend the PSCO meeting during early release on Thursday, February 3rd at 1:40 p.m. in the auditorium. Family members are welcome to attend. We'll cover info on PSCO, how to apply, and details about PSCO relates to high school graduation. And Anoka Ramsey Community College representative will be presenting about PSCO from the perspective of all colleges. Thank you, Cardinals. This was Fedor with you at the announcements. Have a great rest of your day.
Plant your flag and take a look around, because it's time to celebrate Coon Rapids Athletics. From swimming to basketball, we'll bring you all the best highlights. Sports Night is next.
They started 2022 ready to make some history, and game one of the new year had a lot of storylines. On Thursday, they hosted Armstrong Cooper. The Cardinals were just 1-10-1 against the Wings, with their only win coming in the Wings' inaugural season of 2015. Cardinals had won two straight before going on to their holiday break, but coming out of it, they only had one of the team's four goalies available. So sophomore Will Wagner played both the varsity and the JV games. The Wings start the scoring midway through the first. Tanner Roush out of the corner, snipes it top shelf, gets Armstrong. Cooper a 1-0 lead. The celebration was boisterous, but it was to be short-lived. The Cardinals answer at the other end. Good hold at the line by Tandon Bush, pushes backhander to the net. Will Marty there to put home the rebound, his fourth of the season, first in front of the home crowd, and it ties the game at one after one. Cardinals bringing pressure in the second, but it takes a weird hop and springs the Wings. Aiden Cook on a breakaway. Good fake to open the net, put Armstrong Cooper back in front, 2-1. Wings brought a lot of pressure in that middle period, but Wagner up to the challenge. He's going to glove this one, stop 27 of the 29 shots he faced in his first ever varsity game. Third period, Cardinals not to be denied. Nathan Clark to Bresnahan out front. Back to Clark. He taps it home. Clark's ninth of the season evens the game at two. But more importantly, the Cardinals taking the momentum in the final frame. And they feed on the energy. Nathan Klinzing with speed down the left wing and around behind the net. He finds Eli Bowden walking in. Bowden buries the wrist shot, and the Cardinals take a 3-2 lead with 7 minutes to play. Wings bring the pressure, but the Cardinals come together to secure the win. Harry Koval's block in the final seconds, one of several down the stretch for it. The Cardinals, the team really stepping up, and they swarm their sophomore keeper afterwards. Cardinals' first three-game win streak since December 2011. Wagner faced almost 90 shots on the day, a loss at the JV level, but a phenomenal win for the varsity team.
What a day for that young man, that he'll always remember that opportunity. He had to play JV, and then he came out and got his first varsity win against a pretty good team within the Wings. And they've had that back and forth over the years, those two teams, Coon Rapids and Armstrong Cooper, and it's been a good series, and that was a nice win for the
first
program.
First win in seven seasons.
Yeah, nice so win for the
nice,
program.
And their first three-game win streak in 10 years.
Great.
So some great things happening.